walk across Big Moor. On this murky day, the relationship between the stone circles of Barbrook 1 and 2 is fractured, and in this familiar landscape, I have become disorientated. I have strayed from the K-line pathway that follows the ridge of high land between the ring of Barbrook 2 and the giant ring cairn to the north of Barbrook 1. In the swirling mist, my visibility is limited to only a few yards. And although I am unconcerned by my disorientation, I begin to feel a little giddy. To compensate, I focus on the gorse beneath my feet in the hope that I will locate the track from which I have strayed and once again regain my bearings. Unable to locate the path, I glance upwards and I am confronted with a landscape which is both alien and unfamiliar. The mist that had previously enveloped me has now vanished, and I now have a clear view of my surroundings. The air is no longer damp, but brittle and clear, and the abruptness of this clarity alarms me. I am immediately aware that I've strayed down the hillside from the Ridgeway track, and find myself almost level with the Barbrook 1 ring which rises before me. But this is not the circle as I know it. Now complete, the dark stones rise out of their retaining earthen bank. But my temperature begins to rise, and I experience a deep panic. I glance downwards in search of stability, but my feet are no longer surrounded by heather, but by a fine, short, wire-like grass that stretches down to the Barbrook Valley below me.
Scale. Even to us, divisions of our arbitrary timescale can pass in very different ways.